In this video, we're going to look at how you can add a trailing edge flap onto your airfoil and then run some analysis in Xfoil. This video is brought to you by the Science of Flight. Let's get to it. Before we get started, let's have a quick review on what flaps are and what they're used for. And then we'll get into the steps that you can take to add a flap to your airfoil in Xfoil. A flap is a high lift device. This means that it is designed to increase lift and low velocity flight. Aircraft experience a low velocity flight situation during takeoff and landing, and so that's why flaps are used during that portion of the flight. The idea behind a flap is that you are changing the shape of the airfoil temporarily. Flaps usually change one of two things about the airfoil shape. They can either move backwards, which increases the wing area because you're effectively increasing the chord at that point, or they can hinge and pivot downward, and that is essentially changing the camber of a wing. That's the downside of using flap, is that yes, you are increasing lift, but you're also increasing drag. Now, drag's not always a bad thing. Sometimes it's desired. For instance, when you're landing, you want to slow down, so you might be using full flaps because you're wanting the increased lift and the increased drag to slow you down. Whereas if you're about to take off, but you don't want to increase drag because you're trying to speed up to be able to take off. So in that situation, you might look at something like partial flaps. So in this video, we're going to look at changing the airfoil shape that we have in Xfoil to include this flap so that we can run analysis and determine lift, drag, pitching moment. Now, a spoiler is usually up on top of the wing, and it is designed to spoil your airflow across the wing. That's why it's called a spoiler. The idea being that when your wheels touch down on the ground, you're trying to kill any lift that your wing is producing, because that's going to put all of your weight onto your wheels and allow you to brake and stop faster. So that's what spoilers are used for. And you should be able to use Xfoil to look at some of that performance as well. So I'll put something together and I'll leave the spoilers for another video. And in this video, we're just going to look at the flaps that you would find at the trailing edge of the wing. So let's go ahead and get into how we can modify the airfoil shape in Xfoil to include a flap. We've covered the first step pretty well in several other videos, so I'm just going to leave that there by itself and move on to step two. Step two is that we're going to drop down into the geometric design menu. This menu is primarily there for manipulating the airfoil shape. And we'll have more videos on the special features and things that you can do in this menu in future videos. So go ahead and type GDES at the command prompt so that you can drop into the menu. And you'll notice that Xfoil prompts you right there that you are working with the buffer airfoil. As mentioned in a previous video, Xfoil has two different airfoils that it talks about. The current airfoil, which is the one that you use to perform analysis on. And then the buffer airfoil, which if you want to think about it, it's kind of like a temporary cached airfoil that you're tweaking here and there. Then I've got a screenshot here of this second window that Xfoil opens so that you can see the changes that you're making and how it actually looks compared to the original one. Now that we are dropped down into the GDES menu, the geometric design menu, we're going to use the flap command to add a flap onto our airfoil shape. So go ahead and type FLAP or flap into the command prompt and hit enter. This command requires some additional information before it can add the flap to our airfoil. So if you knew ahead of time what those parameters are, you could have just entered it right there when you typed in flap. But in this tutorial, we're going to leave those off so that Xfoil will prompt us on each individual value, and we'll talk about each one individually. So the first parameter that flap wants to know is where you want to put the hinge on the airfoil. This hinge, of course, is just where the flap is going to pivot on the airfoil. So that's why we call it a hinge point. It's going to pivot there like it would if it was attached with a hinge, like a door hinge. Now, something to keep in mind about this parameter is that it is asking for the X coordinate point, the X location, where you want the hinge to be. It's not asking for a normalized X over the chord value. It's asking for the actual X coordinate value. So if your airfoil is not normalized to 1, or it's rotated or moved about the coordinate plane, keep that in mind. Now for this example, I'm going to let the flap pivot at about 80% of the chord. And since I have a normalized airfoil where the leading edge is at 0, 0 and the trailing edge is at 1, 0, that means my X location is going to be at 0.8 or 80% of the chord. The next parameter that the flap command is going to want to know is the Y location of the pivot point. Now there are two methods to do this, and we'll look at the first method here on this slide, and we'll look at the second method on the next slide. Along with the command prompt asking you where the Y location is, Xfoil also gives you some information about the airfoil at the X location that you specified in the previous step. You'll see here it says top surface and bottom surface. Now this is just letting you know that at the X location you specified, the top surface of the airfoil is at a Y value of 0.0485. And the bottom surface is at a Y location of negative 0.0040. It's really nice that Xfoil gives us this information when it's asking us to choose the Y location. Something to keep in mind on this step is that it's asking for the actual Y location of the hinge point. It's not asking for a normalized Y value or a percentage of the Y value. It's asking for the actual Y value. The method that we're going to talk about on the next slide is asking for a normalized Y location, but this one is not. So if we wanted to, on this example, choose a Y location that was directly in the middle of the upper and lower surface, we would have to take average of the top surface Y value and the bottom surface Y value, which gives us a location of 0.02222. So that Y value is the midpoint between the upper surface and the lower surface. If you didn't want to figure out what the actual Y location is, like in the previous step, you can actually type in 999 and hit enter, as it tells you right there in the command prompt, and it will give you the option to specify the flap hinge location as it's normalized by the thickness of the airfoil. That's just a fancy way of saying that you can just tell it, I want it to be at 20% or 50% or 80% of the thickness of the airfoil. So in our previous example, we put it at the midpoint of the thickness. And to do that here in the normalized command prompt, we would say that we want it at 50% of the thickness. So we would type in 0.5 and hit enter. And of course, after you finish specifying the X and Y coordinate points of the hinge point of the flap, Xfoil will show you the values that you chose. The third parameter that the flap command wants to know is the angle that you want the flap deployed to. The angle that it's asking for is in degrees, and a positive number would deploy the flap downward. For this exercise, we're going to go ahead and choose 20 degrees. So we type in 20 and hit enter. And Xfoil will give you some more information there about where it broke the airfoil. Now, when you finish specifying these three parameters, if you look at the second window that Xfoil has open, you'll notice that it has the original airfoil shape along with the modified one laid on top of it. This is nice because it allows you to see how your change that you just entered affects the airfoil that you started with. Now, it can be easy to forget about this next step, step 7, but it's important because if you want to save the changes that you made to the airfoil and actually run analysis on it, then you're going to need to take the shape that you just created in the buffer airfoil and move it over and store it into the current airfoil memory. And the command exec, or just the X, saves your buffer airfoil into your current airfoil. If you forget to do this step and you run over to the upper menu to do an analysis, you'll notice that the analysis you do is not on the buffer airfoil that you just tweaked. So you need to move it over before you run analysis. Now, as you can see by the window that I pasted here at the bottom of the slide, we have successfully modified our airfoil to include a trailing edge flap. Now the last step or steps is to use the airfoil however you originally wanted to use it. Whether you're wanting to run an analysis or save it to a file to use for later or export it to CAD, really whatever you wanted to do with it, you're now able to because we have successfully added in the flap. All right, we're going to go ahead and end the video there, but stay tuned for scenes from our next episode. Just kidding. I'll see you in the next video.